some people will look at it and don't understand that at all, and they should probably just keep going. But other people will look at it, and you know, like I did, and it's almost like, you know, permission to do whatever you want, as far as in this case music goes. So I've been making the guitars for about 5 or 6 years, and a patient that I encountered when I was on call introduced me to the idea of them, and kind of sparked the whole process, really. When you first pick up a cigar box guitar, I don't know that you could say that it sounds like any one thing, because they all sound so different. They are absolutely imperfect, and I think they always will be, and that's certainly fine. My main goal is to make them where they play very well. You know, working with an ENT and head and neck surgery versus, you know, building instruments or anything by hand, it's less precise here. You know, if you make wrong cut, you just make a new neck. You know, you don't do that at work, really, but so to some extent it is, but it's you're not making high dollar musical instrument. Why I keep making them is probably in part because every time you make one guitar, you'll think of something else, so you can constantly kind of reinvent it, change it, add to it. You know, the same sort of things you'd see in any craft or even industry. Now, I certainly don't ever intend or want to, you know, become a master craftsman in the sense of being able to, you know, support myself doing that. I think that would take away from it if I actually had to do it. My name is Kirk Withrow. I work as a head and neck surgeon, and I make cigar box guitars.